Welcome back to Honest News. If you'd like to follow in the reading of God's Word, Mark chapter 4, verse 26. Mark chapter 4, verse 26. And he said, "So is the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground." This is Jesus speaking here. But Jesus is saying, the kingdom of God is as if a man would cast seed into the ground and should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should spring and grow up. He knoweth not how. For the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. First the blade, then the ear, after that the full corn in the ear. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you, God, for the truth of your word. Thank you for the revelation of your word. Pray, Lord, that your word will find a place in the hearts of your people. Pray, God, for the anointing of the Holy Ghost, that this word will pierce through the veil, through the darkness. We plead the blood of Jesus Christ as we minister your word. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. This could be applied to either the wheat or the barley. All right? So, speaking of the blade, let's go look at that verse. Mark chapter 4, verse 28. Speaking of first the blade, then the ear, and then the full corn in the ear. This could be both speaking of wheat, but it is also speaking of barley. So, he says, when the fruit is ripe, as soon as it's ripe, Immediately, folks, he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. Now think about this with me. He says the harvest is come. Now if we think in terms of the barley harvest, we know that the wave offering, the sheaf offering, comes out of the barley, right? Now he says, as soon as the fruit is brought forth, listen now, as soon as the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. Now think about that word immediately. Immediately. As soon as that fruit is brought forth. That tells me he's waiting for the fruit. Amen. We're not waiting for the husbandman. We're not waiting for the sickle, brothers and sisters. We're waiting, or he's waiting, for the fruit. Amen? And the scripture says he has long patience until he receive the former rain and the latter rain. Now, not only spiritually, but even physically, we're in the time of the latter rain. How many know that? But spiritually, we're also in the time of the latter rain. We're in the very season, the very time, the beginning of the harvest. Are you listening? The beginning of the harvest. Now, I've been sharing with you that the beginning of the harvest is the almonds, and then first the harvest begin. Well, excuse me. We begin with the trying to put them in order here so that you can see them in order. The first thing is the almonds, and then the flax. And we have looked at the fact that the almonds represents being alert, being awake, right? Watching. But then the flax has to do with the righteousness of Christ, the fine linen. But then we know the barley follows that. And the sheaf wave offering, the first of the first fruits, comes out of that. Now let's look at this verse. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. He's waiting for the latter rain and the fruit. That's what he's waiting for. And the scripture says he has long patience. We're in that time of the latter rain. There's no question about it. So the next thing is what the latter rain is going to produce. And this is what I believe. I believe the latter rain is going to produce an alertness in the bride of Christ. It's going to produce an alertness, an awakeness, sleeplessness, to where she's completely aroused and awakened. All right? And then it says it was granted to her in the book of Revelation to be arrayed in fine linen, which is the righteousness of the saints. That's what the latter rain is going to produce. Okay? But it's also going to bring in the harvest of the barley. Now, he said, in the time of latter rain, ask ye rain in the time of latter rain. Right? And he said, the Lord will make bright clouds, and he'll give us rain. So in the time of latter rain, ask ye rain. Are you listening? We need to ask. That's where we're at right now. That's the only thing, in my opinion, the only thing that's hindering the fruition, the first of the first fruits, the only thing that's hindering the bride of Christ coming to perfection is that he's waiting on us. He's waiting on us to ask. There's got to be an earnest desire, an earnest seeking. Are you listening? There's going to have to be a real fervency. And it's got to go beyond just desire. We can't just settle for, just an earnest or fervent desire. We got to go beyond that. We need to receive from him that which we are petitioning him for. Amen? We need to apprehend for that which we've been apprehended for. We need the Lord to make this thing happen, people. We can't do it. We cannot produce it. And if he's telling us in the time of latter rain, ask ye rain, well, then that's what we're supposed to be doing, asking for the latter rain. Now remember, latter rain, it doesn't rain everywhere. Amen. We've talked about this in the past where latter rain, it can rain at your neighbor's house and then, or it can rain on your own property in one place and then not another place. I've seen it happen. So he says, latter rain, we must ask for it. It's not going to rain everywhere. Only where there's a hunger and a thirst. There's got to be an earnestness, a crying out. Amen? There's got to be a crying out. Cry out to the Lord for that latter rain, brothers and sisters. Praise God. That's what the Lord's looking for. That's what he's looking for, folks, is that cry, the latter rain, crying out to God. Amen? As far as the scripture goes, as soon as the fruit is brought forth, as soon, he thrusts in the sickle. There's no hesitation there. There's no time lapse. Immediately. That ought to get our attention because, as I've already said, he's waiting for us. In both instances, for the latter rain that he's waiting for, we must ask. And for him to thrust in the sickle, you and I must come to fruition. Amen? We must come to full maturity. He's not going to thrust in the sickle until we do. So in both instances, the Lord's waiting on us. Why are we hesitating? Why are we not really crying out to God? What is it that's causing us to not really desire or cry out to God? And like I said, we got to get beyond desire. Desire is not enough. There's got to be, the scripture talks about craving, desiring, longing for, yearning. Amen. That's all part of it, but that's not the whole. It takes that. It takes that yearning. It takes that longing. It takes that earnestness. Are you listening? But that's not the answer. Amen. The answer will come because of those things. Hallelujah. The rain's going to come because we're asking. We're longing. We're anticipating. Praise the Lord. But this scripture here helps us to understand that he's waiting for the fruit to be brought forth. Amen. Glory to God. He's waiting on us. It's just that simple. He's waiting on us. It says in the scripture, shall he not avenge his elect, though he bear long with them? Amen. Though he bear long with them. That tells me the Lord is bearing long with us. Why are we hesitating? What is it that's keeping you and I from really seeking God? Really, really seeking God, right? With all our heart, with all our mind, with all our soul, with all our strength, where is that real earnestness, brothers and sisters? That inward earnestness, that fervency, where is it? How do we get it? There's going to have to be a real earnest expectation. Are you listening? It's got to be. And I believe God's got to put that within us. I don't think we can do that on our own. I think God will have to put within you and I that earnest expectation. And I believe he gives that to us through his word. Amen? I believe the Lord puts that in our spirit through the word. As we receive the word and he gives us understanding of the truth, it will create within us an earnest expectation to where you and I are looking up with great anticipation. Are you listening? With great expectation. Praise the Lord. Longing, groaning, longing for that redemption of the purchased possession. Hallelujah. Complete state of release. Free. Free, folks. The liberty of the sons of God, the glorious liberty of the sons of God, free from this body. Are you listening? A real deliverance. Amen. We got to go beyond desire to deliverance. From desire to deliverance, we need the Lord to deliver us. That's the sickle being put in. But he's not going to deliver us. He's not going to release us. He's not going to gather in the fruit if it's not first brought to fruition. Amen. So I trust this message will stir within you a greater desire, a greater hunger, a greater thirst, a greater longing, amen, a greater anticipation, a greater expectation. Oh, I feel your presence, Lord. Amen. There's going to have to be a real burning within us, brothers and sisters, a desire, a real craving, amen, to be free from this body of death, hallelujah, free, to be free. Liberated, praise God, to be released from this body and released from this world. Amen. Glory to God. If you've got ties to this world, if you've got attachments to this world, they've got to be relinquished. They've got to be severed. Every tie, every weight that so easily besets us, we got to cast off the weights. Amen. All the weights got to be cast off. You can't have any attachments to this world. You can't have any weights. We're not practicing, brothers and sisters. We're in the real race, so there's no reason to have weights on. They put weights on to practice. We're not practicing. This is the real thing. Amen. We're running the race that is set before us. And there's no reason to have weights on. Amen. We're not beating against the air, showing our strutting ourselves or showing off. This is the real race. And we've got to finish this race. Hallelujah. Finish the course. Amen. Even as Paul the Apostle, I have finished my course. We've got to finish our course all the way to the end. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Blessed be your holy name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. As soon as the fruit is brought forth, amen, he putteth in, immediately, he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.